Hello everyone. So today we are going to be making an airplane. I'm going to show you how to make an airplane. Just grab a piece of paper from your science notebook. It doesn't matter. It has to be a rectangular. It can be a square too, but it's better to have a rectangular to make it like even and a little longer airplane. So what will happen, we are going to go ahead and we are going to... This is just a scrap paper that I've been using for a while. I need you to go ahead and find the middle of the paper, and I need you to fold it inwards, just like this, okay? So make sure it's tight. Make sure to just go along the edge with your finger, just pushing it like this, okay? So I have two flaps from the top, right in the middle. Let me open it back again. Okay, I have two flaps just like this. You can do one and then you can align the second one like that. Okay, so then I will push it. I will make sure that it's all good. So the back side is look like this, right? Looks like a house shape. What will happen now, since we fold it inwards, now we are going to be folding backwards, okay? We're going to go backwards by doing this. I'm going to go like this. I'm going to hold this side, and I'm going to cover it. I'm going to put it on the other side, okay? I will, again, pretend like there's an imaginary line by having this rooftop, my middle of it, okay? I'm going to be literally like covering and closing it up, okay? Let's do it. Okay, just like this. Okay, so I closed it up like that. It's a backwards this time, okay? I had my inwards, then I have backwards, just like this. After that, you should have a paper like this, okay? I hope that everybody has that. Now, let's put it upside down now, because this is going to help you to find it at the middle of this whole thing, okay? So what is the middle of this edge, okay? I'm just going to make an imaginary half. I can measure it, but it doesn't have to be measured, like it doesn't have to be an exact. So I'm going to, you see this middle top, and there's this rooftop. I'm going to be folding, pretend like there's a line. I'm going to be folding from the middle of here to here, just like this, okay? And I need to make sure that it is closing and it's the same line as here, okay? I close it out. You see, it was not an accurate, so it's a little like a half an inch shorter. So I need to make sure that this side is evening out for this side, okay? I closed it up. So now I have this guy right here. Do you see this? So I'm going to be evening this edges with that again. I'm going to be doing the same thing. Or you can do it like this. So you have an imaginary line here. You have a roof here. And I'm going to be closing it up from the middle of it like this. Okay? Let me do that. This is a little tougher because you have like lines of paper to fold. It's harder for me because this is a little thicker paper than the normal construction paper, okay? And then I'm going to be doing the same exact thing for the other side, okay? What I did, I had my halves and the roofs folding it in just like this. And then I am going to fold it again, just like that, Am I done? 12? Yes. So, here is my A plane. I am done. So I am ready to draw this guy. Let me see if I can move this camera so you can see me actually. This is my room. I'm gonna be drawing it from my desk. This is the first one that I made. If you watch my previous video, I'm gonna be drawing this one now with the clip behind it. Okay? Do you see where it is standing? It's like close to, not as close as the recycle bin. You see that? It's a little bit further back. Okay, let's see if this guy is gonna go further or not. It went right there. So, you can tell me by looking at this picture if the airplane one went further than the airplane two. Basically, it's a very easy question. You can see easily by looking at there and here. Okay, so this is how you make the experiment. You see how I throw this first one? I need to throw it 3 times and I need to measure it and I have to write it down right over here. I will write it down. And then I'm going to throw it 2 more times. I will fill out this first line. First line. Okay, and then I'm going to throw this guy right there. And I'm going to be writing down the results in the second line, okay? So, I'm hoping that I will try this guys in the hallway so you can see better, like with the numbers and all that. You can see better the experiment, okay? Thanks for watching. Bye.